Morning, boys and girls. Welcome to the Channel 3 Clubhouse, where you'll find all kinds of fun and special surprises. Now, here is your Clubhouse hostess, Cynthia Kay.
Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to the Channel 3.
And a visit with some interesting people.
Ivanovich and the puppets are visiting with us, so let's say hello to them. Nigel, how many times have I told you not to yawn?
Oh, excuse me.
You gotta cover your mouth when you yawn.
I was just tired.
Oh, I suppose so. You know, Monday mornings are kind of sleepy.
Yeah, I stayed up late and I'm a little tired.
Oh, well, see. Boy, that's why you can't stay up late. Good morning, Lambert.
Good morning. Boy, it's really interesting. Yeah.
Lambert.
It's pretty hard to...
Lambert, huh? Lambert, don't read so closely to the book, Lambert.
Well, I can't see the words too well.
Well, Lambert, but you've got your nose in that book.
My nose isn't in the way. I just... The words are kind of fuzzy.
The words are kind of fuzzy.
I'm trying to see what Yeah, I can see. No, I can't make it out.
Well, maybe somebody spilled something on the book. Here,
yeah,
I'll just look
like
at
did.
It. No, it looks fine to me. The words are just as clear as can be.
Let me see. Oh, they're clear to me.
Sure, those words look very clear. You're reading the TV guide here, so you can see what's on television.
Well, I couldn't make out the words. They're kind of fuzzy.
What's that word say right there?
I don't know.
You
can't
see that? Huh. You know,
I can see it.
I bet I know what's wrong. Lambert, can you see me all right?
Where are you? Oh, yeah, there you are.
I'm right here. I mean, do I look fuzzy or something?
Yeah, you look very fuzzy.
Oh. Well, I'm not. I mean, it must be your eyes.
What's this?
My nose.
Leave Nigel's nose off. You know, I think there's something wrong with your eyes. I think maybe I think we better have the eye doctor check you out.
No, I'm not going to go to an eye doctor.
Now, why not?
Well, nothing wrong with my eyes.
I don't know. If everything's fuzzy, then I think maybe
I can read real big letters like that.
Yeah, but I think maybe we should go to the eye doctor. As a matter of fact, Nigel, when was the last time you had your eyes checked?
Oh, I've never had them checked.
You've never had them?
No.
Oh, well, my goodness, I think I better call the eye doctor and make appointments for both of you to have your eyes checked.
What about you? When have you had your eyes checked?
Well,
I
tell you what, look.
I'll go if you go.
All right, I'll go, and you'll go.
I'll go if you two go.
All right, we'll all go. I'll tell you what, I'll go call the eye doctor right now and see if we can't get some appointments to have our eyes checked. And I hope all the boys and girls have had their eyes checked, because if they watch very carefully, a cartoon is coming right
now. Where is it? Where? Oh, there it is. Mm-hmm.
I had a friend to play with. Here, birdie, birdie, birdie. Here, birdie, birdie. Hello, little friend. Here's some more bread. It's lonesome without anyone to play with.
Now, don't you worry, Casper. I have a big surprise for you.
You have? What's that?
Well, let's go and see. It's Cousin Spooky. Yes, and he's going to spend the weekend with us.
Hiya, Casper!
Now, you two run along while I get lunch ready.
Come on, Spooky. Let's play hide and seek.
Let's go out and scare people. Oh!
Spooky, good ghosts don't scare people. We're going to play hide and seek.
That's a sissy game. I want to scare people.
Now you count to 10 while I hide.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here I come. Ready or not? Now I wonder where Casper's
grow up to be an honest-to-goodness good ghost if you keep insisting on scaring people.
Return to the Channel 3 Clubhouse after these messages.
Tiffany, how many eyes do people have?
2.
Mm-hmm. I'll bet you have to take really good care of your eyes, do you?
Yep.
Why?
So you can see better.
Mm-hmm. And you don't get any more, right? If something happens to our eyes, we only get 2, isn't that right?
Yep.
Yep, so we have to take very, very good care of them. What's your name?
Melissa.
Melissa, how can we take good care of our eyes?
By using your eyes right.
Okay, and how do we do that?
Don't look so close to the book and don't be so close to the TV.
Oh, you're a smart...
smart person. Who told you that?
My teacher.
Did she? She was pretty right, wasn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think so. What's your name?
Jenny.
Jenny. Jenny, what color eyes do I have? I have two of them. Do you know what color they are? What color are they? Well, look at them real close. What color are they?
Black.
Yeah, a little black in the center and some brown, too, right? Yep, that's what color they are. What's your name?
Janelle.
Janelle, what color eyes do you have?
Blue.
Yeah, they're pretty eyes, aren't they? They sure are. I'm going to wish you happy birthday today. How old are you? How many is that?
Four.
That's right. What's your name?
Mary.
Mary, how old are you, Mary?
Five.
Mary, what color eyes do you have?
Brown.
Mm-hmm. What color eyes do people have? Can you think of the different colors? There's brown and what other colors?
Blue.
Blue, that's right. Anything else?
Black.
Yeah. What other color? Maybe some green. Do some people have green eyes? Sure, some people have green eyes, too. What's your name?
Katie.
Katie, what color eyes do you have? Boy, it's pretty hard to see from where you're at, isn't it? Let's see. I think you have blue eyes. And they're very pretty blue eyes, aren't they? Sure they are. What's your name?
Jamie.
Jamie, you know, sometimes we can hurt our eyes. Do you know how we do that? Well, suppose we were out playing and I threw a snowball right at your face. I could hurt your eyes, couldn't I? Yeah, that wouldn't be so nice, would it? I think you're right. Jamie, how old are you?
Four.
Who's this right here?
Kimberly.
Kimberly. Kimberly, what's the prettiest thing you've ever seen?
A rainbow.
Oh, a rainbow's very pretty. Does a rainbow have colors?
Yes.
What colors does it have?
Blue and green and orange and red and yellow.
Lots of colors, doesn't it? Well, I'm going to wish you happy birthday today. Our birthday's pretty special.
Mm-hmm.
I'll bet a birthday cake is a pretty thing to see, too, isn't it? I think so. What's your name?
Amy.
Amy, how old are you, Amy?
Four.
Four, that's right. Amy, what's the prettiest color you've ever seen?
Pink.
Oh, that is a very pretty color, isn't it? It's probably a really nice one. What's your name?
Lorianne.
Lorianne, not all people can see, right?
Right.
Do you know what we call a person who can't see?
Blind.
Mm-hmm. They're very special people, aren't they?
Yes.
Yes. What do you think it would be like if you couldn't see something? It's kind of a hard question, isn't it? I think so. Should we treat people who can't see any differently than people who can see?
Yes.
You think so? I don't know about that. I think they're special people, but I think we should treat them like everyone else, don't you think so?
Yes.
I think so. All right, and it's really important for us to remember, too, that we are very, very lucky if we can see things. What's your name?
Lisanne.
Lisanne, how old are you? Can you tell us? I'll bet you're three, aren't you? Mm-hmm. Can you give me a big smile today? Oh, what a pretty smile. And happy birthday to you. Who's this right here?
Jody.
Jody, how old are you?
Four.
Mm-hmm. You're having a birthday, aren't you? Uh-huh. Jody, pretend that in front of you, you have a package. Okay, we'll pretend. What would you like to be inside that package?
Uh-huh.
Should it be a surprise? You don't like surprises?
No.
No? Would you like to know what's inside of it?
No.
Well, I can't tell you. It's just a pretend package. Who's this right here?
Sally.
Sally, how old are you, Sally? How many is that? What is that right there?
Three.
Three? Oh, you're so right. I'm glad you came to say hello today. What's your name?
Rebecca.
Rebecca, we said that there's different color eyes. Are there different colors of hair? Yeah, what color hair can you have?
Black.
Good at black hair. Anything else?
Brown.
Brown hair, sure. What other color?
Blonde.
Blonde hair. There's one more color hair. Do you know what it is?
Yellow.
Maybe some yellow or some red hair. Can someone have red hair? Sure. I think those are pretty much the colors. What's your name?
Jennifer.
Jennifer, can I have green hair?
Is that a color hair? Green?
No, it isn't, is it? But green's the color of your dress, isn't it? Very pretty. How old are you?
Three.
Well, we're glad you came to say hello today. Who's this right here?
Jimmy.
Jimmy. Jimmy, what color eyes do you have?
Blue.
Blue eyes. Oh, you're so smart. What color hair do you have?
Red.
Mm-hmm. What color hair do I have?
Black.
Mm-hmm. You're right. You're very good at your colors. What's your name?
David.
David. How old are you, David?
Three.
David, what color eyes do you have?
Brown eyes.
Brown eyes. And what color hair do you have?
Brown.
Brown hair. Do you like that color? Yeah, you mean you don't want to have purple hair? No, I wouldn't want to have purple hair either. Let's go over and say hello to our puppet friends and see how everyone is this morning. I did make an appointment with the doctor. Lambert!
I'm not
gonna
do it.
Oh, Lambert!
I'm not gonna do it. I made up my mind.
Now, Lambert, I called Dr. Seymour, and he says for you to come over and see him this morning.
I'm sorry I can't make it.
Well, is there something you have to do?
Mm-hmm.
What?
I have to do some things around here.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Like what?
Well, some very important things. Fixing things.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You're just avoiding going to see the doctor.
Well, I don't want to go to the eye doctor.
Now, just a second. What do you think is going to happen if you go to the eye doctor?
They'll make me wear glasses.
No, now, Lambert.
And they make fun of people who wear glasses in school.
Oh,
I don't want to wear glasses.
Now, Lambert, now, just a second. Here's someone who can explain to you about glasses. Good morning, Professor.
I can explain about glasses?
You certainly can.
Hmm.
You have glasses on, Professor.
Oh, that's right. I wear glasses. I forgot all about
it. That's right. Now, explain to Lambert why it is that people wear glasses.
Well, they make you look so very smart, you know.
No, Professor.
Mm, yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they do, but that's not the reason why people wear glasses.
Well, you see, I had a glass case for sunglasses, and in the morning, I open up the glass case and put the glasses on.
I know, but Professor, why do you put the glasses on?
Well, they look nice on my nose.
No. The reason people wear glasses, Professor, is so that they can see better.
Oh, yeah, of course. You see, I can see you very well, Lambert.
Lambert, it's very simple. Take a look at your eyes. Well, look at my eyes, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Your eyes are sort of like little cameras. Now, that's kind of hard to imagine. But you know how a camera takes a picture? Well, your eyes take pictures all day long, and that's how we can see things around us.
Like Instamatic, yeah.
Now, some people's eyes don't work very well, so things get all fuzzy and blurry, you see. And so to fix that, like you see how it gets all fuzzy and blurry like that? Did you see that? Well, okay, now, what you want to do is, if things get real fuzzy and real blurry, you put on your glasses, and then everything gets clear again.
Everything is clear.
Some people can see up close real well, and some people can see far away real well, but they have trouble seeing, a little bit.
Except sometimes, when I'm outside in the rain, then it's hard to see with my glasses because they get all wet.
Mm-hmm. Now, all of us wear glasses at one time or another. Remember during the summer how you wear your sunglasses? Yeah, well, that's really important.
Well, I can wear sunglasses.
No. Now, Lambert, I don't care if some people don't know any better than to make fun of people who wear glasses, but those of us who are smart, well, we know that glasses are very important because they help you to see better.
Right,
that's
of course.
That's right, okay? So no more procrastinating, or that means putting things
off. I'll go see him.
Okay, we'll go see
him. Dr. Seymour is his name?
Mm-hmm, Dr. Seymour.
Right around the corner,
And do you know what he's going to have you do? Well, he's going to have you look at this chart with pictures on it and tell you what kind of pictures to see.
Oh, good. I can.
And sometimes, if you're real smart, he'll let you read some letters, too.
Oh, good.
Okay, so you go ahead.
I can read letters good. Okay, I'll go.
You go see Dr. Seymour, and we'll see you a little bit later, okay?
I hope he goes.
Oh, of course. And glasses are really kind of nice things.
I like to wear glasses.
Yeah, and as a matter of fact, because of your glasses, you're going to be able to see this cartoon that's coming up really well.
Oh, I can see it very good now.
Yeah, I can, too.
Mm-hmm. I'm tired from reading so much, and now I'm resting them with my sunglasses.
Oh, I see. See, you didn't need glasses after all. How
about
that?
I don't mind wearing sunglasses.
Well, you know something? We should all remember when we see people who wear glasses, never to make fun of them because they really need those glasses.
Right,
you know?
It's very important.
Sure,
I had fun reading the chart, too.
Mm-hmm. Did you? Well, maybe I'll even go down and see Dr. Seymour this week, too, and have my eyes checked out. For a while there, things were looking a little blurry to me, too.
Oh, rest them up.
I'll tell you what, let's wave goodbye to everybody, and then you can walk down to Dr. Seymour's with me, okay?
Okay, I'll do that.
All right, bye.
Hey, kids, don't miss the night of Christmas spirit with the Tiny Tree, the story of a little crippled girl who befriends a tiny pine tree. And when the little woodland creatures witness their friendship, they come up with a plan to ensure the girl a happy Christmas. Don't miss the Tiny Tree Wednesday night at 8:30 on TV Active 3.
Up, boys and girls. Join us again tomorrow morning for more fun in the Channel 3 Clubhouse. This program was recorded.